Welcome to Tokyosaurus. So what's up in Japan? It's only been about a week since we got the first chapter of Hiromashima's new manga, Eden's Zero, and the announcement that the fairy tale sequel will be drawn by a new artist instead of Mashima himself, but the story and the storyboarding will still be done by Mashima, so you don't really have to worry about it straying away from it actually being a real fairy tale sequel, because even the new artist has an art style pretty similar to Mashima, and might actually make it look even better than the original fairy tale, as the art is all he needs to focus on. Mashima actually posted, I'm guessing, a work in progress page from the new fairy tale sequel drawn by the new artist, and I don't know about you, but to me that's a 10 out of 10 for fairy tale art. So that was just a week ago, and they said that there will be more information coming soon, and it turns out soon actually meant really soon, because we already have a release date for the new fairy tale sequel, and that day is July 25th, 2018, exactly 12 months after fairy tale ended. I don't think anybody expected Mashima to release the fairy tale sequel just a month after the release of his new manga, Eden's Zero, but I guess the dude probably didn't stop working when the original fairy tale manga ended, and was definitely working hard this entire year to prepare for all these new releases. The fairy tale spin-off sequel will start on July 25th, released on Manga Poke, which is the Shonen Magazine's app, but the first chapter will also be published in the weekly Shonen Magazine. But what is the story going to be about anyways? The fairy tale sequel will connect from the original manga's final chapter, and in the latest Eden's Zero promo, they released some more information about the fairy tale sequel in a blurb at the bottom. The blurb says, the fairy tale guild has overcome an endless battle with Xerath and Acnologia and has grown stronger and noisier. What things might happen to the fairy tale guild when they go on an exhausting journey, the 100-year quest? This story will start from the 545th chapter, which was supposedly the ending of the original fairy tale story. So the story is literally picking up from where fairy tale ended, with the crew going on the 100-year quest, and we know that Natsu, Lucy, Gildarts, and Laxus are definitely going to be involved in it, and probably Gray and Urza as well, seeing as how they were departing with Natsu and Lucy in the last chapter. Seeing as how the Natsu and Lucy ship is pretty much canon at this point, for those of you who want to see a time skip with them happily married ever after, like the way we saw Naruto and Hinata in Boruto, this sequel just might give it to you, since we are talking about a 100-year quest here. Time just might pass enough in this sequel for us to witness the future of the entire fairy tale crew. Currently, we don't have any information regarding just how long the series will be, and seeing as how they keep calling it a spin-off sequel rather than just a straight-up sequel, I can't imagine it actually being a full-blown sequel in the style that Boruto is to Naruto, and seeing as how Mashima is still dedicating most of his time to Eden's Zero, this spin-off sequel will probably be used to tie up all the loose ends that he probably felt like he had to rush in order to meet the deadline of ending Fairy Tail a year ago. But either way, it's still neat that we will be getting a direct sequel to the original story, which means most likely us as the fanbase would be able to treat it as canon to Fairy Tail. Now careful not to mix this Fairy Tale sequel up with the other Fairy Tale spin-off coming out in the fall this year called Fairy Tale City Hero, featuring Natsu and Lucy as a cop, probably going around town solving crime. Now seeing as how Fairy Tale City Hero will be coming out in the fall, if I had to make a guess, the debut of City Hero should be around the same time that the Fairy Tale sequel would finish up. It just doesn't really make much sense to have Eden's Zero, Fairy Tale spin-off sequel, and a Fairy Tale spin-off all being released at the same time, which is probably why there's no exact release date on City Hero at the moment, as they're still gauging how long the Fairy Tale sequel would be. But we really don't know for sure what the plan is, because there's another spin-off called Fairy Tale Happy's Grand Adventure, written and drawn by another artist with an unconfirmed release date. So it seems like this one is the furthest away from being released, but with three Fairy Tail spin-offs on the way, it's gonna be pretty hectic following all of them even as a hardcore Fairy Tail fan. But obviously most of us are still most interested in the Fairy Tail sequel, and I think we should all just be grateful we'll be getting that one first out of all of the spin-offs. And it definitely looks like Mashima chose the best artist out of the three artists doing the spin-offs to do the sequel, and so in less than a month's time, we'll get a much better idea of where the sequel is going to be headed in terms of scope and direction once it's released on July 25th. So, super exciting times as a Fairy Tail fan, and much respect for how hardworking Mashima is, but I'm more curious as to how you guys feel about the Fairy Tail sequel, starting right off at the end of the original Fairy Tail manga, and what do you want to see in the 100-year quest? So as usual, let me know down in the comments below. Thumbs up the video if you liked it, hit the bell for notifications if you want to be updated with the latest that's going on in Japan, and I'll see you guys in the next one.